Hey guys, welcome back to my kitchen. Alma's recipe here again. It's been a while, I haven't seen you guys. So today I brought you guys how to make beet soup in the slow cooker. It's not hard to make and it's really easy. And now that the time is getting cold and you wanna come home and your food is already ready and be cozy and warm. So this is one of the best recipes. So vamos a empezar. For this recipe, you're going to need 2 pounds of big chink, also called chamorro de res, and 1 pound of big short ribs. 8 cups of water, 1/2 onion, 1 head of garlic, 1 corn, 1 carrot, 1 squash, 1 chayote, 1 potato, 2 tomatoes, 14 green beans, and 1/2 bunch of cilantro, 1 tablespoon of salt. You need a slow cooker, 6 quarters. Start by preheating 2 liters of water or 8 cups of water to bring it to boil, because we are going to cook the meat first for 20 minutes because beef, that type of meat, release some blood. And if we're going to cook it in the slow cooker, it's not going to bring it clear. It's going to be a little bloody or brown. If you don't mind, you can just do it right straight in the cook. But doing this way, it's going to come beautiful, nice and clean. Before anything else, also I'm going to preheat my slow cook. So I'm going to put it in high. To cook the beet soup, we need 2 liters, 8 cups, so 7 cups. This slow cooker is 6 quarters. And then from there, I'm going to be moving to cutting my meat too. To make soup, we always wanted to have some bones. But this one, definitely when you cook it, you see this one, it released a little bit of blood. That's why we want to cook it in the stove first. See the ribs, we're just going to cut it like that, in this way. But it's a different type of meat that you can choose. You can just choose the tail. A lot of people like the tail. I like this one better because it has a little bit of bones, and also because we're cooking in the slow cooker, so we don't want to put a lot of bones because we don't have a big room, but we do want to have meat. That's why I went with this one, with the ribs and the chamorros, and we have the bones, so that's the thing that's going to give it the flavor. So we had 3 pounds of meat all together. So now that we have ready, we're just going to wait until our meat, our water is boiled. I also said that you need to add 2 liters, but you can add it a little bit more if you want. So my water is boiled to this point. We can just leave that over here preheating like in the stove for 15 to 20 minutes just to release all the blood. I also gonna need 2 tomatoes to boil to give you a little bit of color. I need it to cook it, so I'm not gonna use a different pot. Just gonna put it here, maybe like 10 minutes, and then pull it out. Okay guys, so we have preheating our meat. We boiled, we have the meat already, so we just gonna work in our vegetables so we can finish at the same time and put everything in the slow cook. So let's start by peeling like our corn. So we can prepare that first. It has to be fresh corn. You cannot use any other corn. It's better this one. This is also giving a flavor, and we can cut in a different spot. So we're just gonna do it like that. And whatever sizes you want, this one will feed between 4 and 5 people. So you wanna have a piece for each plate. 4 and 6 in little pieces. With the zucchini, we also gonna cut that part out. You can cut it as small as, or as big as you want. And also just, you guys know, this one, sometimes they sell it in the store already prepared with everything you need in like a little packet or carrot. We can peel it. So I'm gonna cut it like a little diagonal, like that. Or you can cut it however you want. It's no right or wrong. And I already washed my vegetables before I start. Definitely you wanna have at least 1 or 2 pieces for each plate. I'm gonna leave this one to the last part because this one, it kinda turns a little brown. So I'm gonna work with my chayote. My chayote, we also gonna peel it. And if you don't find any chayote, it's not a problem if you don't like it or you don't find it. And also you can put some cabbage if you want. Any vegetables that you like, you can put it in the soup. So we cut it in half, and then this one has a heart. You see this one has the seed, so we are going to take the seed out. Cut in this way. So we cut in this part, and we are not putting this part. Some chayotes are really big, some are small. I'm trying to pick one like medium size because we don't have a lot of room in the slow cookers. And my green beans, also if you don't like green beans, you don't have to put it. We can cut this part and this part, and then just half. And you can probably just use maybe like 10 or 12. This kind of way you can hold with your hands like that. See, it's not that many. We're gonna use 1 head of garlic, but I'm gonna take 2 garlics from here. So when I blend my tomato, I blend this one, and we're not gonna peel it. We're just gonna take a little bit the skin and top, and the only thing, I'm gonna cut it in here because I don't want to break it, so I can just take it when it's done. Also I'm gonna need 1/2 of my onion. And then just peeling. Takes the first two layers. And I also gonna leave this part here, see, so that when I pull it out, it stay hold it together and doesn't break it. Like, if you wanted to cut in little pieces, you can. But sometimes my girls don't like it, so I'm just gonna, when the soup is done, I just easy to pull it out. My tomatoes been cooking for 10 minutes, and as you can see, already done. How do you know they done? You see how the skin kinda start peeling? So you wanna take it in now, see? It takes like 10 minutes. This one still need to go another 10 minutes. As you can see, the water is starting to turn a little brown. So I have my potato, so I already washed it and rinsed it up. This is a personal choice. If you wanted to peel it, you can. I'm not gonna peel it. You can use this one or you can use brown. You can use any potato you want. Doesn't necessarily have to be this kind. So I'm gonna cut it like that and then cut it like that. So each person has a little piece. So I have one bunch of cilantro, but I only gonna use half. And this one, we're not gonna use it now. We gonna use it until our soup is ready, but I'm already chopping all my vegetables. So I'm gonna chop it now. I'm just gonna cut this part. This part, I'm not going to use it. So I'm gonna just fold this one in half. And I already washed it and rinsed it. Make sure you wash it and rinse it really good. And kind of keep it a little bit dry. It lasts a long time more when it's dry. So I'm gonna have this one ready now. So you see how much my meat come on. So I still have 3 more minutes done until it's cooking for 20 minutes. I'm gonna meantime go blend my tomatoes and my garlic. Let's get everything prepared when the meat is done. So we're gonna use 2 garlics. And we are gonna use our tomatoes. I'm just gonna cut it maybe a little bit in half so it's easy. This is just to give it a little bit of flavor, a little bit of color. Tablespoon of salt. And we're just gonna blend it. Done. I didn't add any water because it was already cooked, so it was easy. We're just gonna add that one. So this is done. Okay guys, so this is what I'm talking about. You see all this foam and all these things. So if you don't do this, when you cook it like that, when you cook it in the slow cooker, it's gonna be a little brown. Maybe you don't mind, but I do mind. But anyway, so now we're just gonna rinse it out and then we're gonna be done. So be careful, this is really hot. So I'm just gonna put it in here to rinse all the brown spot. And don't worry, cause this one is still gonna have flavor. We're just taking the blood and all that stuff. You will see the water, how the water looks really brown. The meat is still not cooked, it's really like hard. Still, we only cook it for 20 minutes. I'm just gonna rinse it a little bit, so sometimes it has like a little part like blood. And we're just gonna do it like that so all the blood get out. Okay guys, I have everything ready. I have my meat, I have my vegetables, and I have my tomatoes. If you preheat the water like 20 minutes, so I'm gonna just add my tomato. This is gonna give you a little bit of color. Rinse in my blender. They already have the salt, and then we just put that there. If you wanna cook it faster, it can cook in 6 hours, high setting. But if you wanted to go slow, you can cook it in 8 hours. And it's slow. And we're just gonna put the meat. The meat, when right now the meat is pretty hard, you see? But when this one cooks the meat so well, like when the meat is completely tender, it's just amazing. Now that I have my meat here, we are gonna add our onions, garlic, potatoes, and all the vegetables. And we wanted to make sure there's plenty of water and all the vegetables be under, because if they're not under, they're gonna be cooking kind of funny. So you kind of move it just so that way everything goes in the bottom. So I have my garlic over here. When it's done, I'm just gonna pull it out. So I have over here all my vegetables. I'm gonna be cooking this one for 6 hours, guys. I also do have my cilantro here. I'm not gonna add this one now. I'm gonna add it when everything is done cooking. To this point, you don't need to do anything else. We're just gonna cover that and we're gonna let it for 6 hours, and then we come back and this one should be done. This is the 2nd hour. It's been cooking for 2 hours. If you have time, sometimes just stir it a little bit, not much. It's just the vegetables turn around. You don't have to do every hour. I'm just showing you how it looks every hour. So this is the second hour. This has been the 3rd hour. This is how it looks. I'm just gonna move it a little bit. So it's been 6 hours since we start cooking our meat. I'm gonna take my onion, see it comes so completely, so we don't need that. So this is my garlic, I'm also gonna remove it now. And to this point, I'm just gonna add my cilantro now. And I'm just gonna let it cook for another, it can be 5 or 10 minutes, just so that way it gets the flavor of the cilantro. Just gonna cover and we're right back. Alright guys, so there you guys have my beet soup in the slow cooker, 6 hours. on high heat, but I think I recommend you, if you don't have any rice, put it in the morning to cook, and at the end of the day your soup will be ready. The meat is really tender, and also sometimes when you eat it, you can make some rice and heat some tortillas and some salsa, and then just put the rice in there and a little bit of lime and enjoy it. It's really good, like for this time that it's cold and you want to stay healthy with this time of the year, because when you do it in the stove, it takes you forever, this and like that, and I find out it's much easier in the slow cooker. So, alright guys, so hasta la vista.